Towbook's mobile app makes it easy for managers, dispatchers, and drivers to monitor business operations on the go. Dispatch calls to drivers and receive and work jobs on their mobile device. When sending calls to your drivers or managing your own calls as an owner-operator, you'll be able to view all important call data, edit the call if needed, add photos, send receipts, collect signatures, and so much more. You'll notice that any changes on the mobile app will also update the web application in real time. If you prefer to use an Android device, you'll be excited to know that Towbook can work on any Android phone that has the Google Play Store. To get started, simply download the Towbook app from the Google Play Store. Once downloaded, enter your Towbook login credentials to access the app, and you're now connected to Towbook. Welcome to the Android app for Towbook. Let's get started by accessing your side menu. Items in this menu may vary depending on which user type you have in Towbook, but we'll cover them all. If your company requires you to check in for work, you'll want to toggle this button to the on position before every shift, letting your team know that you're available and ready to accept jobs. Don't forget to check out at the end of your shift. Tapping on the dispatching item will take you to the main dispatching screen to view all of your waiting, active, completed, or canceled jobs, along with any quotes. We'll cover more on this shortly. Finding specific jobs is easy. Use the search functionality here to search for specific calls. You can search by customer information, vehicle data, the driver associated with the call, the truck used, or a custom date range if needed. If your company uses Towbook for private property stickering, tap here to view all vehicles with current stickers and any stickers that may need company approval. Tap on any sticker to view additional details and choose to approve, resolve, or delete it here. Select the Impound section of the side menu to view all of your current and released impounds. Tapping on any impound will show all the details of this call, such as important notes, impound information, contacts, and charges. You can even add internal notes or impound notes on this screen by tapping on the plus icon next to each option. To release an impound using your Android device, tap on the release option at the top. Enter the reason for release and all of the release details relating to who you are releasing the vehicle to. If any payment information is received at this time, you can also record that here and add any additional notes at the bottom. Once finished, click the checkmark icon in the upper right corner to confirm the vehicle release in Towbook. Tap on Accounts to see a list of all your accounts in Towbook. Notice the icons in the upper right corner. Tap on the magnifying glass to quickly search for any specific accounts. Select the Filter option to filter any accounts by specific account tags, such as permit parking or handicap zones. Tap the arrow icon to refresh your account list in the event that any recent changes were made. Tapping on any account will bring up the account to either create a new call or view any files associated with that account. You can edit any account information or contacts by tapping on the pencil icon. To quickly add a new account note, select the note icon in the upper right corner, title and add your note, and tap Save. The Digital Connections tab is where you'll find a list of any companies, such as motor clubs, that you're digitally connected to via Towbook. Select the arrow here if you ever need to refresh your connections page. You can also tap on any digital connection to either view the account associated with that connection or log out of the account in order to stop receiving digital calls from that company in Towbook. Just like in the web app, you're able to upload and add any expenses such as fuel, maintenance, repairs, and more. To upload an expense using your Android device, tap on the Record Expense section in the side menu and enter all your details, such as the truck it's related to, the expense category, cost, and any other additional details. You can even upload multiple documents or receipts by tapping on the Take Photo button to reference later if needed. Be sure to tap the Accept button once all of the information has been added. You can access any expenses via the web app by clicking on Settings. selecting the truck section, clicking on a truck, and then viewing the expenses tab. Selecting the truck section in the side menu of your app will bring up every vehicle in your fleet. Again, you can search for any vehicle using the magnifying glass or refresh your truck list using the arrow should you need it. Tap on any vehicle in your fleet to view or change any vehicle details if necessary. You can also add any notes about your trucks here too. Manage company users on the go by selecting the Users section. Here you're able to edit any current user information, such as username and password, the type, or even disable them if needed. Add a new user by selecting on the plus icon in the bottom right corner and adding all the required information. Be sure to tap the check mark when you're done. If your company requires pre-trip inspections, select Equipment Inspection from the menu and press the plus icon in the bottom right-hand corner. Next, select the truck, enter in your truck's odometer reading, and then proceed with the checklist as usual. If something fails, simply enter the failure reason. Optionally, you can take a picture of the failed equipment as well. At the end of the checklist, add any additional notes for others to reference if needed. Once finished, tap the check mark in the top right-hand corner. Be sure to sign the inspection report and tap Accept to automatically send to your manager. Inspection reports created will be viewable at any time in the mobile app. Should drivers need to present them to anyone on the road, such as law enforcement? Towbook has chat feature available where you can chat with your team in either a private group chat or chat about a particular call. You'll receive an audible notification when you have a new chat available. Tapping on Chats will show all chats on your active calls, or you can view previous chat threads on calls that have already been completed. To reply, simply select a chat and enter your response when needed. Clicking on the three dots in the upper right corner of the chat will allow you to view all chat participants. The Map section in Towbook is a powerful tool within both the web and mobile apps. Tap on Map in your side menu. A map will appear showing all of your calls and drivers. You can zoom in and out of the map using the pinch and zoom motion. Each call will be colored according to what status it's in. Tap on any calls to view basic information and select View Details to open the call screen showing all the job details. Tapping on a driver within the map will show you when their location was last updated. At the bottom, you'll notice three different icons of the Map tab. The list icon on the bottom left will show you a list of all of your drivers reporting their location, along with all your current calls. Tap on one to see where they are on the map. Tapping on the home icon will recenter your map and take you back to your home base. Selecting the gear icon will open the map settings and will allow you to add or remove calls or drivers from displaying on the screen. Going back to your side menu, we've got just a few more short items to discuss. Tap on the Settings option. Here you'll find the control room containing the settings for your Towbook app, from location reporting to setting your preferred theme to notification sounds and more. Make sure to take your time here when first setting up the app to customize the settings according to your preferences. Selecting the About option will show you which app version your device is on, along with the app build and other company information, such as your account number. When contacting our support team with troubleshooting questions regarding the mobile app, you'll frequently be asked which version you're on, and you'll find that here. Last but never least, you'll have the sign out option. Signing out after every shift will stop reporting your location to your company. Now that we've gone through every item on your side navigation menu, let's go back to the dispatching section. As mentioned previously, tap on the top navigation bar here to view all waiting, active, completed, or canceled jobs, along with any pending quotes. Use the magnifying glass icon to search for any jobs, the filtering icon to display all calls or only your assigned calls, and the refresh button to refresh your call list. Select the plus icon to create a new call or quote from the Android mobile app using the mobile call editor. Enter all the vehicle details, and notice that when using the plate to VIN feature on the mobile app, it will ask you to confirm the last three characters of the VIN. This security feature is here to ensure the VIN matches the plate and that you have the correct vehicle. Managers and dispatchers are able to bypass this feature if they'd like, but it is a requirement for any tow operators. Continue building your call by assigning a driver, entering all call details such as the account, call reason, and ETA. When adding the location, you'll notice a few different icons. You can enter the service location manually in the pickup box or tap on the request location icon to request your customer's location. If you're already on scene, select the pin icon to pull in your current location and feel free to drag the pin to another location if necessary. If you have multiple drop-off locations, toggle the switch from single to multiple and tap on the plus icon to add an additional address. For the destination, you can also add the location manually or use the pin icon. Additionally, if this is an impound, toggle the destination switch from address to impound, which will automatically populate your lot as the destination. Continue creating the call by adding any important notes. If needed, add contact information for your customer. And at the bottom, add or edit any charges. If you have pricing rules set up in your account, those charges will auto-populate on the mobile apps, just as they do in the web application. Once finished, tap the check mark at the top to save the call, or the three dots to create and dispatch the call to the assigned driver. You've officially created your first call via the Android app. If you're a dispatcher or manager and need to send the call out to your driver from waiting status, simply tap the Update Status button, choose your driver and truck, and tap Set to Dispatch to alert your driver of the new call. When a call is dispatched to you, you'll hear an alert and see a notification. Select the Accept button so your dispatchers know that you've received the call. When you're ready to start working on the call, tap the Update Status button and update your status to En route. Next, if you need navigation, you can tap on the call and then the pickup location to start turn-by-turn directions. When you arrive on scene, be sure to update your status appropriately to let your dispatchers know you've arrived. Depending on your company policies and procedures, your first step when arriving on scene is usually to add photos. Simply tap the camera icon and take pictures of the vehicle, focusing on any current damage to the vehicle to reference in the future if needed. You can also add videos to your calls too. You'll see photos and videos appear on the bottom of the pages as they're uploaded. You can also complete a damage report if your company requires that, or if you're concerned about a possible damage claim against you or the company in the future. To add a damage report, tap on the three dots in the top right corner of the screen. Then select Damage Forms. Tap the plus sign in the bottom right-hand corner, and then change the body type if needed. Next, tap on the area of the vehicle you need to record damages for. Choose the damage type. Add a description. Add photos of the vehicle damages. And then tap Accept. When the damage report is done, tap the check mark in the top right corner. Have your customer sign the report. Agree to your terms and conditions, and tap Accept. Your damage report will automatically upload to the call. While on scene, you can add or edit call and vehicle details by tapping on the pencil icon. As mentioned earlier, our mobile apps have plate-to-VIN technology embedded so that you can enter the license plate and state to quickly add vehicle information to the call. Or you can simply scan the VIN barcode associated with the vehicle by clicking on the camera icon. Afterwards, continue to update any additional vehicle information and add any important notes on the call. Click the check mark when all the information is updated. To chat with your team regarding this call, select the chat icon at the top. This chat will be saved to the job for future reference. If you collect any payments, tap on the three dots in the upper right corner and head to the Payments section to indicate that payment has been received. Tap on the plus sign, enter your payment details, and select the check mark when you're finished. Currently, Towbook integrates with Square for credit card processing. If you choose Square as the payment type and there's a reader connected, it'll automatically open the Square payment screen to accept and complete the payment from there. When all of the call information is updated and your work on the scene is done, be sure to get a signature from your customer. Tap on the three dots once more. Select Add Signature and have them sign for the service. Agree to your terms and then click Accept. Once that's finished, email or text the receipt to your customer by tapping on Send Invoice. You can also choose additional invoice options, such as the ability to hide charges and discounts prior to sending the invoice as well. If the job you're on is a tow, make sure to update your status to towing when you're loaded up and ready to go. When arriving at your destination, you may need to update your status to destination arrival to let your manager or dispatcher know that you've arrived. This status is optional and enabled per your company preferences. When the job is complete, be sure to update your status to completed and tap the check mark in the top right corner. And just like that, you're ready for the next job. Our mobile apps are always evolving, so you'll see new options added over time, and we'll be sure to send out announcements in order to keep you updated when those changes have arrived. If you have any questions about the mobile app or need any help, Towbook Support is here to assist you 24 hours a day, 365 days a year.